No.
So Justin right here is putting in some soap in the scalder, probably about a quarter cup of just, you know, environmentally sensitive dishwasher soap, essentially. And that cuts the water tension of the water to help the water penetrate the bird's feathers better. We say it makes the water a little bit wetter. So we start with that. The scalder's been started before breakfast, so it's already hot. And we'll start with the killing over here. Yeah, just about everybody. Okay, close. All right, so we're gonna get started. These birds, what do we get? You get 36, right? Something like that. Somebody? Not sure.
This is tomorrow's supper.
Yeah. This is dinner tomorrow.
We're going to barbecue these for tomorrow. Yeah.
So we start here with the bird. I grab the bird on top, put my hand on top of the legs and hold the wings so they're not flapping. Go straight into the cone, seat the bird with the head. Give a good quick slice. Now, I'll go into that a little more in detail. If we load, get two, and kill two birds upside down, we don't want the bird to be in the cone upside down without being killed for too long, because then it'll start to asphyxiate because it's starting to suffocate upside down. So, the way I'm killing the bird, let me get these four done so we can go ahead and start the line down. Come here, chicken.
So, Daniel, are you timing the bleed?
No, because by the time I get around this wheel of fortune here, they're going to be long dead. And I'll explain that in a little more detail here in a second.
This the wheel of fortune.
That's right. So what I'm doing is, as you kill it, when you have no eye response, from the humane standards and all that, when they have no eye response, that considers them brain dead. So they're feeling nothing at that point. So you'll see, look at this one dead. So as you'll see here, okay, I've got eye response. If I touch it, it's eye response. If I hit it here, no response at all. He's already gone. Within 1 second, he's totally not feeling anything. Just passing it so